But she didn't want to become squirrel meat. She toyed with the amulet around her neck, gazing at it. Perhaps she could get some of that rust off and see the crest better. She shined it with her silver shining tools.
Young girl?
Excuse me.
May I please enter your house?
Okay.
You're letting me enter your house?
Well, you look kind of cold out there on my
Yes, I'm
windows.
Just freezing out here.
There was a tussle and limbs were flying everywhere and veins and teeth and blood and heads were popping off. His body slumped down off the roof and fell to the floor with a sickening thud. And there was Benedict, covered in blood and holding a head.
What?
Persephone.
What are you doing here in my bedroom window? Come in.
Thank you.
We floated through the wall.
I left the head outside. Strange things are happening in this town. Something has been awoken. I fear my presence has disturbed an equilibrium that has existed for long, long times. I knew I shouldn't, but I followed you home. And just as I suspected, you've become a target.
Being a target means you're going to be closer to me than I want to be a target.
Stephanie, you don't understand.
But as he got closer to her, something seemed to burn his skin, and he pulled away. He noticed the amulet in her hand.
Where did you find that?
His voice was deep and threatening.
Where did you find that?
I found it in the forest.
No, it should have been buried. It never should have.
You don't like it? I'll throw it away.
No, that amulet. It doesn't matter if you throw it away. It will find me. It will always find me. When I came to this town, that amulet was in Europe. And now it's here.
So well traveled.
That thing that I killed, that was my nephew. I come from a family of vampires. And I fear that you already knew that.
I did know.
His heart, or more, his blood sack, felt in his chest.
I'm not like them.
I know. I trust you entirely, Benedict.
They would drain you dry and turn you into one of us. I would never do that. But the temptation is still there.
He gazed sadly down at her as his skin electrified to her touch. His veins couldn't help but burst out of his jaws, and he wanted so badly to bite her, but he pulled away. He hadn't bit a human in years. He craved it so bad.
Quickly. Tell me, do you have a pork chop or some type, like a T-bone steak? Something in your fridge that has blood, that has meat?
I'm vegetarian. Gah!
Cravings are so strong.
Dad might have a stash of beef jerky.
No. It will have been dried out of all of its blood.
Stupid. You can eat me.
Persephone didn't know what she was doing. It was a reflex. She just wanted his touch so badly. It took immense amounts of control for a vampire to stop sucking once they started. He was so hungry. He bit. And he sucked. The thirst quenching orgasmically through his whole body. But he pushed her away. She felt faint. She collapsed onto the ground, still conscious but barely able to stand. He hated seeing her so weak like this. He felt her blood coursing through his veins, and he felt stronger than he had in years.
I feel so strong. That amulet, though.
We should destroy it.
No, no. It's the one thing that keeps me away from you. It's the only thing that will keep me away from you, but it's also the only thing that attracts the other vampires towards you. It's a classic catch 22.
The choice was clear. Get rid of the amulet and be safe, but then be killed by her lover, or keep the amulet and fight off all the vampires that would come their way. Persephone knew her choice. Keep the amulet.
And you will go to battle with me against my family.
Yes.
Come with me.
Chapter 6. Across the forest, in the deep hollows of the trees, two slinky figures gazed longingly at each other.
Oh, Mistress Theodora. I'm so sorry we failed you again and your beauty. Oh, I love it.
Theodora's silky hair flowed down her back, and her pearl white skin shone with youth and beauty.
Oh, Bobby. You're my favorite child.
Yes.
My favorite creation.
Theodora had made 300 other vampires, all her children, including Bobby.
Bobby, there's something I really want.
I know, my mistress, I know more than anything.
Then you shall get it for me.
Yes. The amulet. For it's the only way for you to kill your brother and be the vampire queen we know you are inside.
Nasty Benedict.
Yes.
He barely feeds on human flesh.
I know, even though it's so good. Filled with iron and essential nutrients.
Isara and Benedict had been made together. They had roamed the earth for centuries eating vampires, until Benedict had turned vegetarian. It was the worst thing you could do, the biggest insult to a vampire possible. Theodora had disowned him ever since.
It's all those sheep. Such a sheepish thing to do.
She also loved puns.
Even worse, Theodora. He's turned his back on his own kind.
What?
Here's the head of one of your children.
Oh, Mikey! My poor Mike.
He is but a head now.
I can't be more than boardwalk on the Jersey Shore.
This time he's gone too far, mistress.
far too far.
I'm afraid if you would do that to Mikey, he might do that to any of us.
You must get me that amulet, and quick. Also, to put more salt in the wound, I'll have that chrysanthemum thing he's been toying with.
Oh, the human girl?
Yes. The one that's maybe a flower name that I can't quite get right.
I think it's Persephone.
That's it. Bring me Persephone and with her the amulet.
Do you want her dead or alive?
On the verge of death.
You want to be there. You want to be the one to take her to the other side.
That's right. I'll turn her the vampire. The one thing Benedict can't stand is damning another soul to damnation.
Oh, you're so beautiful, mistress.
Now, let's go to our coffins.
Yes, let us rest. Tomorrow, we shall get the girl.
Chapter 7.
Persephone.
Yes?
Thank you for meeting me. I'm sorry if I frightened you the other day.
No, thank you for telling me the truth. But you should know it's not going to stop me and Benedict from being together.
I was hoping it wouldn't have to come to this, Persephone. You see, I'm in love with you. Yes, me.
Wait! I recognize that scar. Why, you're one of the bears that I saved from a trap.
It was 3 years ago. Flashback. Persephone had been wandering through the woods with her scene when she'd come across the third bear that week caught in a trap.
Sorry, tree.
The poor thing had been lying there for days, near starved, weak and fragile.
Oh, let me get some water here. Here, little bear.
Had been the drink of life for the werebear. And as he looked up, barely on the brink of death, he gazed into her glassy blue eyes, and he knew this was his love. Forward, forward.
I remember that day. Oh, you healed up. That's so good.
I did. And ever since then, I've been watching you in the woods. And I've been seeing you free the children of the woods. And so I've sent them. I sent them to keep an eye on you. Persephone, you're meddling with dark and dangerous powers. I fear you might be in the middle of a vampire war. Vampire war. That's how I say it.
You're right. I am in the middle of a war. I don't know how to fight, and I don't want to hurt anybody. But
in wars, everyone gets hurt.
I love Benedict. When he touches me, electricity shoots through my body.
Oh, Persephone, do not tell me these things!
And it was like candy in my mouth. I was sucked away, every inch of me was just on fire. I didn't know my body could do those things, as he was gently but seductively sipping on it. It was so sensual.
It is now, but I fear he's going to turn you into a monster like him.
And if I have to destroy him to save you, then so be it.
I gotta get back to Benedict. Please don't hurt me, buddy.
I cannot promise what I will do in my bear state.
Chapter 8. Benedict was just...
You're there, Josiah.
Petting the horse.
You're a handsome fellow.
I had just fallen, and Benedict was coming round for his morning calling on his lover. Night calling on his lover.
I thought you had superhuman senses. You couldn't feel me sneaking up on you.
Sometimes I get entranced by animals. Once you stop killing them, you learn to appreciate them.
I feel the same way. Since I've stopped eating meat, I just want to hold all the animals close to me.
I suppose you have some questions about my existence. It's natural.
It's true. She'd been burning with curiosity all day, just waiting for the sun to fall, where she might ask her, the love of her life, where did he come from? Where is... why? How? All the questions.
I've been alive a long time. 197 years. I've seen world wars, the advent of the airplane, TV.
Have you loved before?
Once. And I was forced to make a choice. Save the woman I love, or let her die. And to keep her alive, I sacrificed my own. She grew old, withered away and died like I should have done 150 years ago. But that's not what happened. No, I've stayed the same age. Here I am. The only way I can be removed from this god-awful earth is to be killed by another vampire with one of these wooden stakes in the heart.
Persephone's heart ached to hear him long for his own demise when she so longed to have him around forever. But the sadness in his eyes was deep and endless. As she gazed into them, she saw many, many lifetimes of heartbreak and sorrow. She thought to herself, how could someone so beautiful be so sad?
Oh, Benedict, the life you led turned me into a vampire. I want to be with you forever.
It's a curse! To be this, to feel no warmth, except that momentary bliss that you remove the life of someone else.
Doesn't sound so bad. To be with
you. Make it so tempting. The amulet. It's here for our protection. If I were to drink your blood, I would be hopeless. Do you feel that?
Mist
They're coming.
Was crawling in.
They're coming.
I don't know what to do.
Not just mine, but others. Were bears?
Benedict's hearing could hear a pin drop from miles away.
Benedict! I know you're in there!
A voice came from a quarter mile away.
And tonight it's a crescent moon!
Well then, come on in.
An enormous bear entered the stable. His fangs were a foot long and his claws were even longer. And his shaggy hair was matted with anger. He reared up on hind legs, threateningly.
Don't hurt him.
But Benedict was in front of him in a flash. He wasn't scared of a werebear. He had fought thousands of them in his day. He leaped him up and threw him across the table. But the bear was back on his feet in a moment. And he smacked him across the face. And Benedict flew up and hit the stable walls.
I can't handle seeing this.
Persephone ran out of the stable, desperate to go find help. As the two men continued to fight. Chapter 9. Running across. She stopped. It wasn't a squirrel. It was a man, and he took her.
Ah!
Chapter 10, back in the stable. They continued to pummel each other until.
Did she hear that?
A full squirrel. My family. The enemy of my enemy is my friend.
If it means saving her, I will help you.
Chapter 10. Across the forest.
Persephone. We've met once before. I remember you from the alley. Theodora, oh, that amulet of yours is very intriguing. You've done well, buddy.
Yes, I'm in distress.
Persephone knew she was in danger, but she could only think of Benedict. He was still in the barn with the bear. Who knows if he was, well, already dead, but still intact. Or with his head off.
Bobby, go get her father.
Yes.
I have a present for you. I also have your horse. Don't hurt my horse.
What's going on here? Oh, shit.
And your father.
What?
Now you have an option, Persephone. I could kill them both, which I'll probably do. Or you can choose one and give me the amulet. Not a very good option. No, it's not.
I don't know what's going on here, but don't give this woman what she wants. She's, oh, she looks evil in a sexy way. I don't like it.
Look into my eyes.
What are you doing to me? Oh. His eyes glazed over in a trance.
See? I don't even have to kill him. He can do whatever I want. You know what? Let me untie him. He doesn't need these.
told me to. She's your new mother.
And you could be my new daughter. If only you'd give me your necklace.
No, I said I needed to keep it. I told Benedict I'd keep it.
Listen to your mother and give her what she wants, sweetheart.
Daddy knows best. It's just a necklace, I guess. Sorry, Benedict.
Once the amulet was around a vampire's neck, it no longer could be used against them. She was powerful. Everyone else was powerless against her.
Don't need that silly old fashioned horses. I kind of like your father. Maybe I'll keep him around. You are a monster. But I could be your mother, darling.
Now that she didn't have the amulet, she was completely exposed, completely defenseless, just a weak mortal. And she bit. Chapter 11. Running through the forest, Benedict and the werebear kept stride with each other.
You know I can fly. You want to meet
I was gonna
back.
Say
no.
Right.
No. Wait. No. Yeah. You know what? That's right. I'm not a bitch. You know, this is much slower than me flying.
Like, maybe I should ride you.
Okay.
And with a giant bear on his back, he launched into the treetops. Skimming their soft surfaces. Squirrel flying out of the way as he cut through the trees.
Bear!
He landed. He could hear soft voices still far away, but with his keen hearing, he heard everything.
Don't you want to be my daughter?
He knew that voice. He knew both of those voices.
What do you smell?
Blood. Horse blood.
No.
And human. Theodora!
His voice was deep and booming through the trees.
Yes, brother.
Let us settle this once and for all.
So it shall be done.
And she was there in a flash.
Come, Persephone.
Persephone.
Persephone was on the brink of death. She had perhaps was slurpy blood left in her.
No.
Bobby, come in.
Yes.
She would surely die any minute now, unless something was done to prevent her.
She's almost my daughter. Benedict. I'm sorry. I didn't keep the amulet.
He saw the amulet glowing around his sister's neck. He knew he could never defeat her if she held it in her power.
You always were one to settle our differences in underhanded ways. The amulet, really? You're not strong enough to defeat me without it?
Don't mock me, brother. Of course I can defeat you at any moment. I just think it makes my neck look prettier.
Here. Give me Persephone and you can have the werepear.
Bobby, what would I do with a werepear?
Come on.
Do you want the werebear, Bobby?
Persephone,
it might be his last while she was still warm and fleshy. He cried a single bloody tear.
I'm so sorry.
No. Here, go to the werebear, for he loves you and he'll protect you.
With my last ounce of strength, I'm sorry, tree.
Bloody sick.
Yeah. Goodbye, Bobby.
Puddle time.
Bobby joined her cuddly form. There was no time. She had to be saved. She would either become vampire or die.
No!
Save her!
No!
Not again! I cannot! But you can.
I can't let another one.
Then let this one live forever with you.
2 days have been the best of my life.
He dragged her limp body over to prop it against the three intertwined trees of the lovers.
Here. For you, my love. I'm so sorry. I love you.
And as he said the words, I love you, the three trees unwound and turned back into gods.
True love could have turned us back from trees. For we are true lovers, three.
Intertwined the rest of time. And you and I.
We are intertwined
the rest
of time.
Their mouths interjoined in a true lover's passionate kiss forever. The end.
It's going to be a completely different vampire romance. Come check that out. That's October 27th. But thank you so much. We'll see you around.